Folks, I have another sponsor that I'd like to mention, a wonderful soap that's just on the market for the holidays. And you ladies can sure do yourself a great favor if you'll go down to your supermarket Monday morning. They're staying open until noon Thursday for you to buy some of this new soap, spelled F-U-G-G, Fug. There's no soap in the world to compare with Fug. Rinso, chip soap, does none of them. Fug has so many advantages. Just as, for instance, ladies, suppose your husband works on a dirty job, like in a coal mine, on a truck, in a garage. When he comes home all dirty and nasty, when he opens the door and walks in the house, tell him to go fug himself. That's a good one. Now, next, thank you very much. Next week has been declared Garbage Can Week all over the world. Garbage Can Week begins next week, and that's in you ladies' department, so I'd like to ask you, when you go home tonight, bend over and look in your can. Is your can gritty, grimy, or greasy? You have to check your can. Your neighbor could be using your can. And you don't know what your neighbor might put in it. I suggest you fug your can. Or let somebody fug it for you. If you do use fug in your can, when your husband comes home and bends over and smells your can, he will say with that smile of pleasure, "Your can has just been fugged." Since next week, since next week is Garbage Can Week, the makers of Fug have this extra special offer on. With the purchase of one box of F-U-G-G Fug, you receive absolutely free without cost red tape, signing your life away, a 16-ounce sample size package of their latest detergent, spelled S-U-G-G.
Sug.
So remember, folks, wherever you go and whatever you do, if you can't fug it, you got the idea. She's crying. Give her a hand. Really, this is the truth. I'm from the country, and during the war, they made a lot of money at home, and they didn't throw it away on foolish things like food, rent, and clothing. Everybody bought something worthwhile, something that you could get a hold of and call your very own. Everybody in my hometown bought a jackass. Everybody, I mean everybody, bought a jackass. Even the little bitty kids, they had an ass of their own. Preacher's wife had the biggest ass in town. I know, because I rode her big ass all the time. Biggest ass ever been on. You can see the muscles in her big ass. Sometime I'd ride her ass so long her ass was sweating, I'd slip right off her big sweaty ass. No, that's because I didn't have no saddle, you see. Well, just like I told you, she had a husband, he didn't have such a bad ass himself. He was a preacher. I rode his little narrow ass once. Boniest ass ever been on. You can't ride no bony ass. You got to have some meat on your ass and you get ready to ride. Yes, sir. Get you a big fat ass in high old silver. One Sunday, the preacher came to church and started preaching. He put his ass outside. See, the congregation came to church on their ass. The preacher came to church on his ass. And I hadn't been in town long. I was on my ass. The Preacher put his ass outside the window, came inside and started preaching. One of the sisters in the back row was was reading the gospel. And something caught a fire in the back pew, and she jumped up and hollered, "Help! Somebody save us!" Everybody ran outside, snatched their ass, and rode off. But the old reverend, he didn't leave. He stayed there and counted the collection, got caught out inside. He figured his ass might get scorched outside. So he took a long running jump and jumped out the window to land on his ass. But somebody had stole old reverend's ass and wasn't there. And the reverend fell down in a deep hole in the ground. That's where they found him, in this hole in the ground. Just go to show you, don't it? Some folks don't know the ass from a hole in the ground.